Hey everyone, I am Mohammed Fazari. I'm a JavaScript developer with Serve in Bangalore. This video is about my hackathon submission. My application is a search engine for your custom CSV dataset. So how this works is that it provides you an opportunity to upload all your datasets at one place and then and you can execute a search across all the datasets just right from one place, and then you can see the results in a consolidated fashion. This is a utility and a plug and play based tool that can work for any CSV dataset, preferably for the ones with the headers. So what's happening behind the scenes is that user uploads a CSV file from the React frontend. The file gets stored in one of my directories from on the backend. And then as we do that, as the upload completes, we are doing a bit of post-processing. So we are creating the search index headers for the CSV name. And as we created the header, we are iterating over each CSV rows using our parser and then adding dynamic indexes as we iterate over a map. And the values are stored appropriately against those indexes using an hset command. Alongside, we're also populating a suggestion add dictionary. That is, we are creating a dictionary of each column and appropriate row values. These two in combination allow us to get three results. One is exact text match, another is prefix based matches, and third one is fuzzy based matches. All of this takes only a few seconds, and once that's done, users notified of the file upload. User can then execute a search which triggers these commands for every CSV files that we have in here and for every CSV headers within those files. And then all the results are again consolidated and sent to the front end as a payload which can be traded. Now, quick look into our application is that we need a user to get started. So I've already created the user. The user exists in cache. Now, once we log in, the user is checked whether they are in the cache. And if they are a valid user, a JWT token is dispatched. I can see there's no data files that have been uploaded already. So why don't we just go here? Before we do that, we can try and execute a search to make sure that there's nothing there to give any search results yet. Now I have a few CSV files. Now this is a really small CSV file. So you can see the upload completed successfully. Now we are ready to execute search. So you can see the words are matching there, are written and their text word match. Also you can see that what's the appearance of the word and which data set you're seeing this results from. Also you can see the fuzzies also working fine. Now probably if I wanted to do a prefix based matches, that's also gonna match properly. Now, what if we have a really huge data set such as this, which has over 43,000 row values? Now, it opening itself is gonna take a lot of time, stalling and all those stuff, and searching, executing something which you're not sure whether this exists in this CSV file or this CSV file is a nightmare. So thankfully, this plug and play tool have an option, which is really simple. Just go here and upload the file again. You can see the file size is 38 megabytes. Now, uploading the file again takes only a few seconds. It's running all those indexing and post-processing as I mentioned before. And once that is done, you can see the values are reflecting here. Now we can execute a search here. Yet. Now you can see that the values that are matching for this prefix are coming from both the data sets. One is from the first data set and another is from the second data set. Now you compare it with the size of the CSV file that we uploaded and then the latency within which you're able to get a response is mind-blowing actually. Now let me try and search for a device, probably a phone. So this, you can see there's a product match, and what's the highlight is if your CSV is having so many columns and although the rows are written to you, you don't know which key is actually matching with the value that you are searched for. In this case, the value that we searched for matches with this key and that's appropriately highlighted for us. And similarly, fuzzy based matches are also done. Now there's been effort done to minimize the duplicates that are coming up in the search results. And finally, I wanted to show the JWT in action. So as I said, all of these things are behind a secure middleware. So now if I log out, now we should not be able to execute anything because the JWT token has now been destroyed. Now that's all for my submission. I hope you really like it. And that's all for me. Thanks everyone.